Look, we've got distressing confirmation now that a seventh person has passed away. Obviously, as we said before, the numbers, the death toll has been rising throughout the evening. Originally, it was said that five people had passed away, then ambulance later confirmed it was six. Now we can confirm a seventh person has passed away here at St Vincent's Hospital. Now, I spoke to ambulance authorities not long ago and they described those injuries that the people sustained on the ground there. Those injuries have been described as trauma injuries. We have heard from witnesses on the ground that clothes were used to try to stem the bleeding, and we've heard many descriptions from witnesses on the ground at just how much blood there was. So trauma injuries is how ambulance authorities are describing what we're seeing here. Among the injured, of course, as we've heard, that baby, that nine-month-old baby at the Children's Hospital at Randwick, very seriously injured, that nine-month-old baby, and the baby's mother has been brought here to St Vincent's Hospital. Now, of course, we did hear not long ago from the AFP they are dealing. They say they're assisting New South Wales Police in investigating what they're calling a mass casualty event. Here at St Vincent's Hospital, we saw a police officer leaving not long ago with brown paper bags, what we can assume. We can assume that those bags contained evidence that, of course, hasn't been confirmed, but no doubt that will form part of the investigation as it continues to unfold. But a very serious investigation, police investigation, assisted by the AFP, a New South Wales Police here on the ground at St Vincent's Hospital. And to recap, a seventh person has passed away, the death toll tragically rising.
Goodness.
Serena, thank you for that. And we understand that the seventh person, that includes the attacker who was shot down by that senior female police officer. Serena Andaloro then confirming that the mother of that nine-month-old baby had in fact been taken to St Vincent's Hospital. So I want to go now to Angelique Opie, who's at the Children's Hospital in Randwick, to find out if we have any more information. Obviously, Australian hearts are just gone out for everyone, but particularly this little baby. Do we have any more information about its condition?
Well, completely, and we don't yet have an update on the condition, but we do know this nine-month-old baby is a young little girl. Her mother was sharing social media videos of her just moments, hours before this tragic situation unfolded. They were spending an ordinary Saturday afternoon at Westfield Bondi Junction. That nine-month-old baby was stabbed multiple times in the chest and in the arm. We understand from witnesses, the mother and child were two of the first people who were transported by paramedics to hospital. We also heard of quite a heroic act from two men, two brothers, who stepped in and used clothes to stop the bleeding of this young child. Now, of course, doctors and nurses are being praised across Sydney right now for the work that they are doing. Medics will be working around the clock to stabilise this child. Of course, one of eight victims who are all in hospital as we speak. Some of those distressed loved ones are here at Sydney Children's Hospital at Randwick and also at St Vincent's Hospital. Just a distressing situation for them to come to terms with tonight.